If you're purchasing new appliances, you're probably reading online reviews, asking your friends for their advice and learning all the manufacturer specs. But you've probably seen a lot of buyer's remorse and comments from people wishing they had bought something different. Wouldn't it be great to learn all the nightmares to avoid up front so they don't happen to you? In this new series, that's exactly what we're gonna do. We'll show you the common and uncommon pitfalls and mistakes in every category, from starting a project to delivering without the several different types of damage that can happen to your home. This time we're talking about ventilation. Let's get started. One of the biggest mistakes you can make when planning a new kitchen or starting a new renovation is improperly planning your venting. Many vents currently in the market haven't been redesigned to accommodate the heat and fumes of newer high output ranges. Here are the three important points to consider: not having the right CFM or capture area in your hood, not planning proper ducting, and not planning for fresh air return into your home. First, always vent properly. And if you have a vent, use it. Many people have invested in the right hood, only not to turn it on when they cook. And here's what happens when you don't. The EPA now says the air inside your home can be 2 to 3 times worse than the air outside, and could be exponentially worse if you cook a lot. And here's why. When you cook, especially with a gas stove, but also with induction and electric to a lesser degree, you're projecting tons of fumes in your home, like nitrous oxide, formaldehyde, and carbon dioxide, along with the grease and the lingering odors that go with cooking. What compounds the problem is stoves have higher output, and homes are built better nowadays, so the outside air doesn't infiltrate back in your home, causing gases to stay in your home for a longer period of time. So buy the right hood, and if you have one, turn it on. Next, failing to plan to have the correct CFM and capture area when purchasing a hood. You may think that having an underpower hood is the big problem, but most people understand the rating for exhaust, commonly referred to as CFM. CFM is cubic feet per minute, or how many cubes of air are exhausted per minute. So you want a higher powered hood in the 6 to 1200 CFM range. Many people underpower the hood when the cost is minimal, between a 6 to 1200 CFM. There are better ways to cut costs in your kitchen with appliances, so spend a little more on ventilation. If you cook, that's not the biggest problem. The biggest problem is capture, which is defined as depth and height of the hood. The highest output burners are in the front of your range. Even a basic gas range has 2 15,000 BTU burners or greater on the front. You want the hood to at least cover them at 23 to 24 inches. Yet many people who cook will buy an over-the-range microwave, downdraft, or shallow hood, thinking it will work. The smoke, grease, and gases will billow past your shallow hood, especially from the higher powered front burners into your room. When you vent down or use two or more transitions, you reduce the static flow of the exhaust, limiting the effectiveness. To vent properly, you either vent straight out, because that's where the exhaust naturally headed, or straight back when you're on an outside wall. Mistake number three is you have to be sure you're abiding by your local makeup air laws. And even if you don't have any, you want to be sure to have a fresh air return into your home. As an example, that 1200 CFM hood is removing the equivalent of a small room of air every minute. So without a fresh air return, that air is made up from your garage, attic, and furnace, which isn't exactly healthy. In new construction, you can run a fresh air return through your HVAC, or place a fresh air return at least 10 feet from your stove on the opposite wall. We explain this more in depth in a separate video, and we'll link to that in the description for you. Now, many people have commented they're stuck with an old downdraft and don't want to remodel or can't vent to the outside in a condo. Here are three ideas if you like to cook. First, cook on the back burners if you can. Back burners of all types are less powerful, but are covered better by every type of vent. Secondly, invest in a good air cleaner. It doesn't cost a lot. I'm partial to the Sharp HEPA because it will circulate more than the other brands and emit negative ions to cancel out the positive ions of odors. Lastly, open your windows. I know that's not the boldest idea, but it's important to get fresh air into your house. You just learned why most hoods don't work due to lack of capture or bad venting. To review, make sure your new hood has the right CFM or capture area. Always have proper ducting. Straight up is best, followed by straight out. Plan for a fresh air return into your home and abide by local makeup air laws. You can click here to watch more videos in this series. And thanks for watching.